Now to a rather deflating decision for Husker fans.
A decades-long tradition is done, at least for now.
University scrubbed the first touchdown balloon launches because of a worldwide helium shortage. KATV News Watch 7's Jeremy Maskell's live. Jeremy?
And Rob, this impacts much more than Husker football. We use helium for research, medical treatments, even some welding. More than 10 years ago, the federal government said it wanted out of the helium business by 2015. The plan? Spur private sales, but experts say that never happened, and now we are running out.
Celebrating that first touchdown, it was a decades-long lift for football fans.
Like a celebration of here we go, we're ready, we're pumped up.
First score of the day, let them go. A lot of pride in that.
But even a powerhouse like Husker football can't get the gas. Stores like Mangelson's are rationing what they have.
It's only walk-ins. We're not taking any orders ahead of time now.
Sue Ratty used to fill hundreds of helium balloons for one order. Now you can only take 20.
Right now I have enough helium for, I'm going to say, 50, maybe 75 balloons.
Their backup supplier can only offer so much, so staff make creative alternatives using air-filled balloons. The shortage spans the world.
Actually, where they find most helium that they use is in natural gas deposits.
It's simple supply. We're using helium much faster than we're finding it. Dwindling supplies mean customers like hospitals take priority. For instance, the Nebraska Medical Center uses helium in this brain imaging scanner.
Staff at the medical center tell me they are set with their own supplier through the length of that contract.
Ratty says most customers can understand the shortage, but these days don't even ask about some spare helium to vault your voice.
No, that is not good for you.
Now Husker football says there is enough helium on hand to fill 2,500 balloons for the first football game this fall. That's about half the normal release. They'll look for alternatives in the future. As for the shortage on the whole, Congress is considering changes that may ease the shortage, but there's been no action on that bill since May.